Hello there, welcome to Scott Lynch Pop. I'm Scott Lynch, and in today's video, I'm going to show you some simple stretches and workout routines that we can do along without weights. You'll see the room here, I got one and two different kinds of workout machinery here. They're not really easy for me to use, and honestly, I don't think they get used near as much as what they'd like to be. Anyways, also have this classic leg lamp. This leg lamp is what they use on the Christmas story. If you have any information you want to add about that, please feel free to leave me whatever comments that you'd like in the comment section, and I'll get to them as soon as I can. So I will be using today in this video are these rubber bands that you see here. These are called TheraBands. These particular TheraBands are nothing but a round rubber band, but they do provide quite a bit of resistance. They have five different colors. There's this one, and the further you go on down, the stronger they get. Truthfully, they, like I said, they're very strong at this. I'm probably just going to use this light, this green wood right here, just because it's the easiest one to use. But anyways, let's go ahead and get started. Alright, the first thing we're going to do, whenever you start doing a little exercise, the one thing I'd love for you to do is go ahead and get a stretch. So our first exercise is going to be a simple stretch. Now to start things off nice and easy, the first stretch with either arm, I want you to go ahead and reach over, you end up grabbing part of your ear almost, just tilt your neck a little bit sideways by keeping the opposite arm straight. Now is what this does, gives you a nice tight stretch feeling right through this part of the neck. Now it's getting loosened up. Like then, repeat that with the other side. Go ahead and stretch it out. You can do this two or three times with each side. Definitely does help stretch your neck out, but if you're anything like me, it also creates a little bit of an object for you to have balance for it. After you're done, stretch your neck from side to side. One other way to create a good neck stretch is go ahead and grab the back of your head and repeat the same thing and tuck your chin down into your chest and try that exercise again. It's going to help straighten out a little bit of the back part of the neck, which is a big key because not only is it part of our neck, but also our shoulders. And it often, when you're in a wheelchair, one thing that will start to bother you later on is the rod in your cup and your shoulder there. The rod in your socket, if it's not worked out just right, can lead to a lot of problems. All right, the second exercise I have is going to be another stretch. Is what you want to do, take one of your arms and just grab the elbow and try to pull it to the side. You can feel quite a bit of stretch in your shoulder region whenever you do that. Like that, you're going to do this with both sides. And as far as when I'm gripping my arm, I have to be gripping it right at the elbow. Now other people can grip it here in the where your tricep area, but either way you want to do it, do as much as you can, but don't make yourself extreme discomfort. You want to make sure you just have a nice stretch to it. All right, next up for number three is what we're going to focus on. I focus on how to do the arm exercise, how to stretch your neck out. One little simple idea, go ahead and do some shoulder shrugs. Try to get in a big circle. Moving as round as much, both your shoulders, as much as possible. And then now I like to do it forwards, but also try it in reverse. Now, I obviously haven't gone through the whole thing. I just need you to do this about 10 times each. They say you could actually do two or three repeats of these. Stay with the other exercise, just to make sure you get nice and stretched out before you really start working out. We'll go ahead and move on to number four now. Number four is going to be fairly simple. We got a few different ways we can do this, but in advance, it's going to be fairly simple, especially without using the TheraBands right now. The first thing we're going to do is a straight punch up in there. Just stretch out your entire arm. Be like, so you want to do this a good 10 times or so, and repeat there. Do it about 3 sets of 10. So before you get a nice workout with the arm. Like that, only going up with one arm, you can also switch it up and do both arms at once. And of course, as you do this, you get a little bit more of the balance control issue, especially in my case. But I know everybody out there is going to be a little bit different. Like I said, not only can we do frontwards, we are not upwards, I mean, but we can also do frontwards, doing a simple punch out. And again, same thing goes, do it with both arms, and go nice and slow, try not to jerk it back too much, or punch forward too fast. We don't need to be flipping out of our chairs. Again, do this with both arms. Gives you a little bit more of a challenge. Anyways, do all that stuff they say. Good recommendation, do it 10 times. But do 3 sets of 10. And that should give you a good workout for that. Alright, number 5. This is probably going to be one of the funnier things to do. And you might not this less into music. If I want to do it, get with both the arms out. If I can bounce enough, I want you to go ahead and rotate those around. And just go clockwise. Counterclockwise or clockwise. Start off with them like a Xana. Obviously, I'm having a good difficulty doing these just right. But the idea of a hubbly is fairly simple, as it will create good balance there. Just rotate your arms and both the clockwise and counterclockwise direction. And once again, you want to do this in 2 sets of 10 in both directions. Like I said, I'm not quite the best, but you know, if you do all these and you use them and practice every day, should be able to get this quite well. Practice makes perfect. Obviously, I haven't been practicing too much, but I have done quite a bit of research on different ways that we can all exercise and try to make it fairly easy for all of us. Now I'm going to move off to my next exercise. Alright, now this exercise is going to be a simple called a sword draw. And what we're going to do, just act like you had a sword attached to your hip. Reach down to where it would be, just lift your arm straight up, and when you do, go nice and slow with it. Put it back down, and reach up again. Remember to keep it nice and slow. Now you'll notice with this exercise, you feel quite a bit in your shoulder area. It's a good one to help work out your rotator cuff inside your shoulder. Now go ahead and I'll move on to our next exercise. Okay, now this is exercise number 7. Gonna be a little bit more physical active. Want to make sure I have enough both of your body inside frames to go to arms. Now is what we're gonna do, take the arms out just like this, and then we're gonna bring them up to our chest here and cross the arms just like this. As you can see right now my arm, my right arm right here is over top of my left arm. However, I'm going to swing my arms back out, and then I'm going to bring them in again. But when I bring them in this time, I want the left arm to be on top of the right arm. So we're alternating each way. So we swing them out and swing them in. Swing them out and swing them in. This out and all the heads, as you can see, with a little bit of balance. But again, it's really giving our shoulders quite a good workout. Just like any of my other exercises I've showed you, they recommend to do this in sets of 10 and do these 10 or 3 sets of 10. That way you get a nice good workout going on. Now we're going to move up to lucky number 8. fracturize the brain. I've got to focus totally on doing rotator work on your shoulder. Now, basically, when I say that, let's keep our elbow at a 90-degree bend, and we're just going to slowly move our elbow out as far as we can get to the go, and bring it back in, out, and back in. Try to keep this as smooth as what you can, just to make sure you don't really do any damage. Like I said, nice and slow. This really comes into effect when I use the bands, which I am going to show you at the end of the video here. I'm going to try to show you how I can use the bands. Okay, and for number 9, there are actually going to be 2 exercises that I'm going to combine into 1. The first exercise of number 9 will be just a simple chin tuck, is what they call it. Basically, you take your chin. I was giving yourself a double chin. Try to move it far back into your neck as possible. And what this is going to do is going to concentrate a lot on your back muscles inside the back of your neck. Help to stretch as I give those a good workout. If they have lots to do, that'd be very beneficial. Go ahead and try to pitch your shoulder blades back at the same time. So you can also think about trying to shove your chest out just a little bit whenever you do this backwards with the chin there. And you'll notice that you'll feel a little bit up at the front of your chest working together whenever you do both these exercises at the same time. So you gotta pitch your shoulder blades back. Basically, that's one of the reasons we did a little bit better. Shoulder rolls up, loses up before we start this. Simply because I want to make sure our shoulders get a good workout whenever we do this. Now move off to number 10. Now for lucky number 10. As they always say, never skip leg day. And that's something that I haven't got to do yet. Me, I don't have much control of my legs anymore. But I can do a little bit. And if you can do a little bit, I appreciate if you go ahead and try these, as they help affect a lot of your core balance and all that later on. Has put a lot of strength into the lower part of your stomach as well. All we're gonna do is a simple leg lift. Yep, here I'm gonna try to go. Like I said, I'm not too great at these, but I will go ahead and hold on to the armrest and try my best of it. First thing I'm gonna do, they're not gonna be much, but you'll see a little bit. I'm going to start with my right foot first, and I'm just going to try to lift it off the ground. Just a little bit there. And you can see, I can't do it that well. Hopefully, you can show me up and do a little bit better. Then I'll also go ahead and walk to do the same thing with the left foot. And try to move just left foot up a little bit. Sometimes you can't do it that much. But after you work on it for a little bit, get more control of which muscles to move and to activate. And now I'm going to move off to a lot of TheraBand stretches after this. I'll give everybody a little bit more of intensity of a workout. And this is exercise number 11. For this one, fairly simple. All I did in advance, I made sure I took my seatbelt off. Look there, but over the side. This is what they call the wheelchair push-up. And basically, a lot of us probably do this all the time and don't even think it's really a big exercise, which is something they recommend quite a bit in physical therapy. Basically, I have my hands on my armrest and I just give it myself a push upwards and back down. Keep doing that in several different times. Of course, I always tend to fall forward. My waist push up and back down. Do that several times. One way to learn about keep balance there, you might want to consider backing up into a wall before you do this. That way you don't really fall but in one direction. I'll move off to our next set of exercises. However, our next sets, I'm gonna follow the TheraBands, which I have still sitting right here beside me. I'll go ahead and show you a few different ways that we can use these. to work out a little bit stronger. I'm about ready to start all the therapeutic exercises. As we talked about before, I've got 5 different therapy bands. There's this one, we got a blue and a yellow one, and a red and black over there. The blue one is light, yellow one is medium, red one is heavy, and the black one is extra heavy. This one here has to be extra light. It's easiest for me to stretch, and therefore, it's also the easiest one for me to show you how to do a few different things out there. So I'm going with the yellow, the green one here. And with these bands, the more often you use these exercises, the better and stronger you will become. And you can move on up and use whatever color you'd like there. But please, don't do more than what you can. Also with these bands, their little secret is, whenever it comes to getting a grip on these, I like these here just because they're solid round bands. They're fairly easy for you to get hold of. Now, if you do have a little bit of trouble with your grip, one little trick I've seen people actually use like a highlighter or a round burner marker, something that is about that size. It could even be a small little pipe, a small PVC pipe. But to put it out there, just gives you a little bit extra grip with the theramans. Anyways, I'll go ahead and show you these exercises. This is number 12. As you see, I've got the light theraband here, the green theraband. If you look down there at the bottom, you'll see where it says extra light on there. These are quite strong. The extra light is more than sufficient for me. This is what we're gonna do right now on this one. It's a simple deal where I brought it in the arm. This time I'll be doing it with a theraband. You know, you get a decent grip on this theraband and both hands there. And like I said, I'll just do a very slow out and then back in. And I'll do this a few times. As you tell when I'm doing this, I want to keep my shoulder perfectly at a 90-degree bend right there. And I try to only use the shoulder. I'll use the forearm muscles at all with this one. And of course, do this on either side there. And it also helps with balance, as you can tell. Do it with both arms. And just have to build up a little bit of your shoulder muscle. Helps you from getting the rotator cuff tear. If you're not doing fine, that's why a lot of people end up having to go to a power wheelchair simply because I mess up their rotator cuff. I go ahead and move on to our next exercise now. This is going to be exercise number 13. Very simple, I'm just going to hold the theraband while base here at the shoulder, and the other one I'm going to hold my hand. This is going to be very similar to the punch out that we did. I'm just going to go straight out with it, and I'm going to go straight back in. And basically while I'm doing this, I'm also controlling a little bit of a stabilization to make it nice, smooth, in and out. And after you've done this a few times, like I said, if you want, go ahead and switch up arms. Do a little bit with your left arm. But like I said, you want to make sure you go nice and smooth. You might have to work this a little bit. Some other deals that you can do while you're in this same position, we can also go straight up with it. And again, same idea. Just want to keep it very smooth and not jerk that much with it. Do with both arms. You can even go out to your side there. Any way you want to do it, but just make sure. Well, basically, you see me, I'm going a little bit jerking around with it. Ideally, I'd like to get very easy with it, very smooth. So, in other words, I'd have to work on this one just a little bit. And like I said, I'm using this light theraband. This is the green one. You see with the other ones here behind me, I go all the way up the buckwheat over there, which is 50 pounds, but I guarantee you I'd be sick eating quite a bit with that one. Let me move off to our next exercise now. Now I'm going to do exercise number 14. This is fairly simple. You can see I'm using the same light green there, Ben. I'm going to tight around right around the knee bar then, where my knees are on this wheelchair. Anyways, I can just grip that one and go straight up with it and straight down. Again, I only wanted to bend the bicep muscle. I want to keep it very smooth. All the way up and all the way down. Now this one, honestly, I could probably use a stronger there, may not, but I don't want to be showing off too much. Cause I don't want to show off. This might get myself into trouble. Anyways, fairly simple. And this one you can actually do on either side with both arms at the same time. I tried to do that personally. I've actually ordered another set of TheraBands, so I can use the same weight on both sides. However, I haven't got the second shipment in yet. Let's go ahead and get you on to our next exercise. This is going to be exercise number 15. As you see, once you get the light green TheraBand, just going to go ahead and drive around my head a little bit more just to make this TheraBand a little bit shorter whenever I grab it. Now I've got to rub dry my hands a little bit. I'm just going to take it and I'm going to go behind my head and stretch it out a little bit. This is actually a lot more difficult the way you think it'd be. But anyways, part of this is going to help straighten out part of your muscles there, scaffolding in the back. And a lot of times, it can help you do a little bit of balance as well. So this is another very popular exercise. Once again, the main trick is don't overexert yourself and make sure when you come back together, you go nice and smooth. I gotta get ready now for our next exercise. This is gonna be exercise number 16. This is one exercise I want to get two different sets of these TheraBands so I can do it on the other side of the wheelchair. However, I'm just going to do one right now. This exercise is a good exercise for the tricep of your shoulder there. And you can see I've got the TheraBand, one end tied around my arm, the other is around my wheel. Now, in my case, I have to go around the entire wheel. Some of you all might just be able to go around your head to him, but my case, that was not an option. Anyways, for this one, it's going to be fairly simple. I just go straight down with my arm, and then straight back down. Straight up with my arm, and straight back down. While I keep a fairly smooth action, that way I don't risk hurt myself by slamming my arm into the wheel or something like that. Also, I'll have it to where that will slip around my elbow. Want it to be a little bit stronger, you just grab with your hand. If I can get my thumb right through the part that I want to. I've had a little bit of difficulty to just slit out my hand once, but nonetheless, just going very smooth as far out as you go and very smooth back in. Like I said, if you try to go fast, easily slip your hand back into the wheel because of a little bit of injury. Like I said, I'm going to slow out and try to make it nice smooth. Everywhere I go in and try not to jerk. That's a good thing with these TheraBands, and make it nice and smooth for you. Now I'm going to move off to our next exercise. Alright, for exercise number 17, I've still got the second grade TheraBand. And what I'm going to do for this one, with the arms sticking straight out, we're going to have a grip with both hands on the TheraBand. Let me make sure I can see how you grip. There we are. Right here, the TheraBand. And we're just going to try to straighten it out as far as we can with both hands fully extended. This window will also help you with balance and all that. Straight out and try to stretch it as far out as we can go and try to fall over to the side. And once again, you want to get it very smooth out and very smooth back in without falling over as the key. Try one more time here. Smooth out and smooth it. That's the one to lead over just a little bit. I'll go ahead and we'll get ready for our next exercise. This is going to be exercise number 18. Now 18 is going to be very similar to the sword draw that I did earlier without a theremin. This one will consider using a theremin on it. So I've got the green stripe. Starting off with my left arm. Starting off down here at the right hip. Now we go straight up with the left arm. Just like this. And you can see the main object here, of course, is going to be get very smooth. Try not to jerk on your way up. And on the way down, you don't want to go too fast. Keep it just nice and smooth. I'm going to go ahead and move off to our next exercise. Alright, this will be exercise number 19. As what we're going to do for this one, this exercise really focuses a lot on your chest. Make sure you get a good strong chest. And what we're going to do, we're going to focus just with the theremin. Get the right grip is important. Having it on all the way through the theremin. It's like it is now. But while you're gripping it, want to make sure they get these bands with my bottom two fingers just like that, and I repeat it on this side. So I gotta grip all this there, man. Why can't let go? Because if you did, you're gonna smack yourself in the face with it, which is not great. Anyways, with your arms extended at a perfect 90 degree angle on both sides, pull it out as much as you can. Oh, it's like a butterfly. You may not get too far, but that's all right. You just gotta work and build yourself up. We'll do it a few times. And this is not how many times it's recommended for you to do. In order to get full exercise, what they always tell you to do is do it at least 10 times in a row. Anyway, pull it off and be nice and slow. Nice and even whenever you pull back. The main trick is just you don't want to let go of their brain, because if you do, it's going to smack you right in the face. Anyway, it's going to get ready for our next exercise. This is going to be exercise number 20, and it will also be the final exercise I do for this video. It's what this exercise is mainly going to focus on. And getting rid of the back flaps while it got right on your arm here, right in the tricep area. A lot of people refer to them as bat wings. For this exercise, what I do, I've got, as you can see, that green thing made here. And it's just simply hooked around the back push handle of this chair. And for this exercise, I'm going to put my elbow up as far as I can go. And from there, I just use the triceps of my arm and go straight up with it and then straight down. And I'm trying to make this as smooth as possible. I don't want to be jerking as much. The more you do this, the easier it will get and everything else. And get, you want a few repetitions of that one. And then when you do, take a small break, and then do it again. If you have any questions at all about any of these videos that we made for these exercises, please leave me a comment, give me a thumbs up if possible, and of course, if you'd like to, please go ahead and subscribe, that way you never miss another video. And if there's any other questions, leave them in the comments. Otherwise, thank you all for watching. Now I got my thumb through here. A little bit more resistance on the left. See, it is a pain in the ass.
Oh, it's still going if you don't try.